Hey guys, Andrew here, and welcome back to another episode of Qbeh-1. Last left off, we did that delightful level that took forever and days and days and days and days and days to do. So now here we are, walking around in a giant circle that has no meaning or purpose, but was put in the game anyway. Isn't that fantastic? I love it when there's just useless areas in a game. So, I think we're almost done. That was the last level we did was 4. This should be 5, and afterwards is 6. And then I think that's okay. I get another useless area, and that's it. Once world 6 is done, I believe this game will be over, which is a good sign. Who doesn't love the end of a game? It's a good feeling, a feeling of accomplishment and satisfaction and everything else that comes along with good. Okay, well now I'm paranoid because that other side had nothing, but this side might have everything on it. Huh. Paranoia will get you nowhere, kids! Don't ever be paranoid, if you're ever paranoid, just kill the thing that makes you paranoid, then you don't have to ever be paranoid about it again. Alright. So, this so far has been just a literal walking simulator. There has been no puzzles in the past, 2 minutes that we've been doing this. So, hopefully puzzles will begin soon, shortly. Or not. Alright, well, there seems to be a thing right there and a thing right there, which probably opens both those doors. So let's just start going through doors and see what sections we've got. Another red. And a walking puzzle. Ah, how quaint. So stick one there, stick one there. It's just enough for 2 if you have 2. If you don't, it's not enough. Ah, there's just not much to say about this game 90% of the time. Except, I am like 100% certain that's why they named it Qbeh. Some people might be like, ah, they were trying to go for the, you know, it sounds like cube. But no, it is Qbeh. Like, it is just an eh game. Ah, delightful. So I have to sacrifice that one block to progress forward. Presumably because I need another. So go ahead and give me that cube. Put this here and put that there. See how this goes. I need another blue. So I need 2 blue to do this. Unless there's a thing back here. There is not. I guess I could do this, which would allow me to get up here. Which I'm assuming has another blue hanging out. There it is. Wow, this is so far fucking uninspired. Oh, another checkpoint. Can I activate it? There we go. It goes even further, even deeper. Where does this deepness end? Ah, in the next room. So I need to take my belongings before I leave. So let's see. Can I do that? Not really. No. Boy, oh boy. What is this one? Okay, that one just brings me up. So I'm gonna go ahead and take my belongings, and then I'm just going to put a blue right here. Then we're gonna go up. Oh, and I'm gonna put a blue here, and then a red right there. Why would I need to do that ever? Why would I need to do that literally ever? Okay. Ah, that's why I would need to do that literally ever. Wait, no, that doesn't explain anything. That explains literally nothing. Fucking hell. So, I am waging a guess that the entire reason is so I can do this, jump over here, take this, and now I have everything I need to go. Okay. Now I have to take that entirely long, strenuous walk again. Ah, fantastic. Nothing more delightful than taking a walk around the park. You know, that time when sometimes you're walking around a park and then you see a dog and you go, oh, that's a cute dog, but then you realize it's not really a dog, it's just a dead animal sitting on the side of the road that you thought was a dog because you were just a misguided youth. But, you know, sometimes life comes at you that way. Sometimes life comes at you in a way where you think dead animals are dogs. And other times life comes at you in a way where sometimes you wish you were that dead animal. Where you sit there and painstakingly pray and hope that your death will come in a nice, quick fashion. That maybe your death will bring about the birth of a new revolution of anti-games. Where people will just not make games anymore. Maybe all indie developers will just cease to exist. And you can live in a utopia where no longer are you bound by the constraints of shitty games, but instead are given the fruitful joys of, I don't know, sadness, camaraderie, hate, disgust, too high, just right. That. Give me that. Yep. Great. Okay. That here, actually, I'm gonna put this right here. Nope, that makes it too high, actually. Alright. Let's see. So, the same process over again, except I have three, and I need to remember that I have three. So let's. Can I stand there? I can, but it means nothing to stand there. So let's jump up here, grab that, let's jump over here. And grab that, build a staircase, take those. That purple is long gone now. Why did I do this? There's something back here? I guess there is. Ah, a blue. A blue! Alright, so before I leave, should probably take my purple, since I'm sure it's gonna come in handy with me later on. And I'll take these two blues. So now I have three blues. I need one more blue to make it all right again. So let's go, or no, I need 2, 4, 5 blues. I need 5 blues to make it all right again. That's pretty tough. Alright, so the two blues are always an entrance key. But see, you need 3 to get through this door. How did I know that? I didn't. I just happened to do it. Alright, give me this blue back. Holy shit. Wow, that was, punishable. Okay, wow, that was a lot easier than I thought it was going to be, actually. That took almost no time at all. Okay, so now I have 4 of the 5 needed to get through this area. So, here's the last bit. I hope you have what I need. Ah, see, you need 3 to get through this door. But now I have 4, which means I could probably do it. Yep. Well, now I feel bad for picking the back door first. Because now I feel like I've just kind of skipped all of the hardships of wasting time. Alright, so... bring two right there, bring one right there. Take this with me. Alright. That's a problem. I'll put this right here. I'm gonna put this... Oh, I could just do that. There's two greens over there. So let's see what these greens are about. Am I supposed to take these greens? Yes, I am. Wow, this is gonna be one hell of a show. That back there. So I can do this. That should be good. Ooh. That was almost dangerous. Huh. What an interesting dilemma. Just have to build a very slow bridge to get over there. There we go. Okay, so now that that bridge has been built, it's just a matter of... Okay, I'm gonna do this. And I'm gonna do... Let's just be on the safe side. Yeah. Getting rid of two is a good idea. Alright, and I'm up here. Now I only have one red block, which I don't think I'm gonna need more red blocks, so it's A-okay. A-okay. Alright, so now I have five blues, which means I can exit this area. So one, two, three, four, five. What is that gonna do? Is that like the five cube worlds that I've been to so far? Oh. Right, another slow-moving thing. Okay. Any minute now, we'll get there. Any minute now. Any minute now. Any minute now. Any minute now, there we go. Okay, had to kind of brute force my way through there because it was going incredibly slow, slower than I could ever possibly desire a fucking end of a puzzle game to go. Hey look, a giant cube. What the fuck is this thing? All right, well, there's a thing right here. Okay. I managed to find a giant cube and a glowing pad, but I don't have any of my old cubes. So, what does this mean? Who knows? Not really much to do here. Am I missing something, or... dealio with this. Huh. Oh! Just standing on it makes the cube rise. Okay. To space with you, cube. To space with you! Oh wait, what's going on? Man, it is really starting to pull. Wow, okay. Are you all right there, Cube? Like, you are spinning violently. All right, let's get to the other side of this. Nope, this cube is pulling me in. I just hang out here. Oh, I literally cannot touch the ground. All right, well, whatever, let's go into the cube then. Power up the Atlas. All right, the Atlas has been powered up. What did we get? Tell them what they've won. What did they win? Oh, a black screen. Oh, okay. Space. All right. Do I need to click on that or? Nope. Just hanging out there. Oh, is that the end? Oh, righty then. I didn't realize I was at the end. I thought there were 6 levels. Okay, well, that is Qbeh-1, the Atlas Cube. It is finally over, and holy shit, this is probably the most enthusiasm I've had since I started this game. Qbeh is a game I would probably never highly unrecommend, or I would never highly recommend to anybody, and it is a game I highly unrecommend to people. It is incredibly boring, incredibly easy, and almost tiring. And not in the tiring way of like, oof, I'm exhausted. Tiring is in like, I'm gonna fall asleep, I'm so fucking bored. I get it. It's an indie game. I can't expect it to be on the same par as a bunch of other stuff, but at the same time, there have been other indie games that are puzzle games that are a lot more effort and thought put into them than this is. I guess a lot of people say that the real money is made in the Steam Workshop, where the community maps are a lot harder and take more effort and yada yada yada. But honestly, I didn't buy this game for 89 cents so I could play community maps. I bought it so I could play the main game and see how well that does. I kind of don't care about any of the mechanics of the game. I don't like the cube thing. It's kind of shitty, especially since a lot of it rests on the idea that you are not allowed to have access to that cube. And a lot of it is weird because cubes are just being placed sporadically. You have no purpose or reason to be doing any of the things that you're doing. I hate games that have no plot. Mindless puzzle solving is not interesting to me. I need like reason and purpose to keep going, otherwise it just becomes a nothingness game, where it's that kind of situation of like, hey, why do you wake up every morning and eat food if you don't want to? I don't know, I guess I just have to. That's what Qbeh feels like. Why am I playing more levels? What's the purpose? I don't know, you just do. No, I just don't. So, yeah, Qbeh is garbage. And if you like it, I'm sorry for your loss. That is a very drastic loss to taste. But if you hated it, then yeah, congratulations. We have the same exact viewpoint on Qbeh. I think it's, as a puzzle game, it kind of fails dramatically in being actually a game that requires critical thinking. There was almost no time that I felt I got incredibly lost in that game. Besides the one time where I just forgot about looking through a hole in the wall. That was it. That was like the only time I've ever been like, ah, fuck, what do I do? I'm trying to think of anything else to say about the game, and there's not really much else. All of it's just kind of a blur of boredom. I hate jumping in this game. This game has the shittiest jump mechanics. There's a lot of, the fact you can't place cubes in front of other cubes that you're standing on is just absurd. It makes literally no sense, like I've said, like, fucking several times. Minecraft figured this out somehow, and I can't believe you can't. And it makes no sense in terms of adding difficulty to the puzzle, because you need to be fucking ahead of the curve. You need to think about what you're doing before you set your cubes down. Fuck you. All right, I'm already in a fucking cube world. Someone had to place those cubes somehow because they're just floating in space, and I bet you they didn't fucking just float there placing cubes up. Nope, they probably did it by standing on a cube and then placing the cube right in front of them. So, fuck you. That's stupid. Well, yeah. So in any case, I'm gonna go ahead and say thank you guys for watching. If you like what you see, go ahead and click subscribe. Otherwise, leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me the worst Qbeh-1 player you've ever seen before. As always, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and bye! We'll be right back.